and we're going to be covering proposals as well as advanced proposal design today. And this will be on the web as of tomorrow, Thursday. So to start off with, in order to create a proposal, we must have somebody in our contact database. So in order to do that, we're going to click on Contacts, and you're going to click Create a New Contact. That will open up the contact screen. I'm going to assume that you guys already know how to do that. So in this case, we're going to select a contact. And if I want to choose by prospect, for instance, I'll come down here and I'll look at my buddy Ed can buy here. So now that contact's chosen, under the Proposals tab, I'm going to click on New Proposal. And that will assign a proposal number, it will assign a proposal name. So the standardized proposal name that we have now is Proposal for the Can-Buy Residence Created on Such and Such Date. If I want to change that, I can change that right here. Maybe I don't want the Created By to be on there, for instance. So I can change it like so, and that's how it'll be printed. So I select that. The first place we want to go to after that is Proposal Setup. And of course, I've used this customer name previously in the past. So having this on there already, generally what you want to start with is deciding what disciplines you're going to sell and what zones you're going to put products in. Now my recommendation is the first time you start to set this up, you come under the discipline, you open this list up, and come down to Edit, and edit the way you want this to come out every time. So if there's things that we have in there in the standardized program you don't want, get rid of them. If there's things that aren't in there, add yours in. And put them in the order that you typically want your proposals to go in. I find that standardizing that helps you all the way through the entire path from proposal all the way through realization of the product being installed. Then we've got our zone list here, and you generally want to put every single small room in the house, if you're doing whole house automation, on this zone list. So that if you have to go back later and put like a Wi-Fi WAP or something like that in, it's already in there, it's in the spot it's supposed to be. So I've built up a little small house here so we could do a small proposal. And then I've assigned I can assign the salesperson here. It's assigned to me, I can assign it to I Could Sell. And this person will be the salesperson on the project. And you can see the proposal is not locked, it has not been accepted yet, so we're just going to start this. So if any of you have seen the Power Tools training class where we talk about product assemblies, quick specs, and product packages, that's what we're going to use here to get this started. So we're going to go to Proposal Items. Under Proposal Items, I'm going to go to my System Quick Spec. So we'll sell this person a distributed audio system and a home theater. So I've got a bunch of these quick specs already made up. We'll go to a Crestron system. I chose the Crestron system. It already chose the fact that it's a whole house music system, so it'll put these items under whole house music. I've got a few rooms listed down here. So in the dining room, I'm going to put a 4-inch touch panel. I'll put a black touch panel in the living room. I'll put a white one in the kitchen. We'll do a Sennheiser dock in the kitchen. Something in the master bedroom, something in the master bath. And then we'll put some speakers in. And as you can see, we're just clicking on these. Now you'll notice these are all in red. And the way that works, we'll just put in a basic AES there, a mechanical room. Yep. Okay, the way that works is these are all still in red, which means I could come back here and I could change these items like so right now. Once I press the Update Proposal with Quick Specs, that makes it part of the proposal. And at that point, if you need to change it, you'll go under Proposal Items to make those changes. So I'm going to go ahead and click Update Proposal. And now it'll transfer those items onto the proposal. If you would, please mute your phone. It's star 6. Yes, thank you. Yeah, somebody else out there still has their phone unmuted as well. If you would, please mute that. Star 6. Okay, so we've put this quick spec on the proposal. Now let's go put a product package on there. So moving to product package, the first thing to do when you get to product package is always click the show all. And the reason for that is sometimes there'll be a phase turned on in some other area where you were working, for instance. And if it's on, then when we start clicking on items over here, it may go to places that you're not expecting it to go to. So I'm going to filter this by zone. I'm going to say that this package is going to go in the theater, and I'm going to put it under the discipline of home theater. And now I'm going to search for a theater package over here. So I'll pick my home theater silver package. Pops up down here so we can check and make sure we like it. And I'll go ahead and click insert. That will load it in the room. Okay, now everything's loaded in there, but there are some issues. This package that we developed a while back has an HD DVD player, which we're not going to sell because it's old technology now. So what I want to do here is I want to add a Blu-ray instead. So what I'll do to do that is I'll come over to Pick Product. And we'll search by Sony, since that's the Blu-ray player I have in here. And here's our Blu-ray. So I'm going to click on the plus sign and add that to the package. Now this DHS-8 has a sort order number of 19. I'm going to go ahead and give the Sony the same number. So I'm going to put 19 there. What that's going to do is it's going to move it up into this area, which is where I wanted to show up in the proposal. And then at that point I can now get rid of the HD DVD player. If I click the red X, it'll bring up a dialog box asking, am I sure I want to do that? If you hold your control button down, in most cases throughout the software, if you hold control button down then hit that red X, it will just go ahead and delete it without asking you that question. Just a little trick there. Okay, so I now have a home theater package. I have a distributed audio package that we're going to sell this person. So the next thing I want to do is I want to look at the money detail of it and make sure that the dollars line up the way I think they should. So I click on money detail. I'm going to decide how I get paid for it. So in this case I chose a new construction plan. And so here's my 10, 20, 25, 35, 10% plan. And then I'll click on update. And what update's going to do now is going to take all those items that we placed in the system and bring the dollars in. And I've set this up that it's a taxable sale. Labor's taxable on it. I've got a 5% miscellaneous charge for parts. I'm not giving any discount. And I'm using the auto calculation feature. And for those of you who are not familiar, what this does is it takes all of the labor types, 1 through 5, which is typically engineering, pre-wire, trim, final, and programming, and it multiplies them by whatever percentage you have here, thus creating a project management time period, essentially, and a dollar amount that you can charge. So this package looks to be about $36,000, seems right to me. So the next thing I want to check is I want to go check the labor detail and make sure that the labor numbers look good. So coming under the labor, we look and there's 6 hours of engineering, 14 hours of pre-wire, 12 of trim, 6 of final, 12 for programming, and then 5 for project management. So maybe I think that's okay. If I don't think it's okay, there may be an area like, for instance, I usually use the living room as an example. Maybe the speakers that are going in the living room are going into a faux painted wall, and it's going to take a lot of extra time to get that done. Well, what I can do is I can come over here and again always click show all first and then filter by the room we want to look at. So here's the living room and the speakers are triads. So I'm going to filter by triad. Now, if we take a look at this triad speakers, I might say, well, because of the whole faux finishing situation, I think it's going to take an hour per speaker to do that. So I'm going to give them an hour here. And then on project management, I'm going to build a half an hour into each one of those speakers because I'm going to have to go out there and check on it and make sure it's good. So by doing that, making this alteration, this changes this one room's speakers just in this proposal, does not change it anywhere else. And it will keep your job costing correct as well. The other place you can change numbers like that is the difficulty factor. We look at the pre-wire and I might say, okay, 14 hours should be enough. However, they're using some kind of specialty beams, or the contractor's a little more difficult to deal with, so I want to beef that pre-wire number up a little bit. Well, we can change the difficulty number by simply clicking here. I can change it to 1.5. You can also, by clicking again inside that box, you could change it to different numbers, like there's 1.25, change it to 1.75, you get the drift. And because this is a two-space box, it looks like it has rolled upwards, but it's actually still 1.75. So what it's doing is it's taking your pre-wired dollar amount per hour, multiplying it by the hours you said it should take, and then multiplying that by the 1.8, which gives us the 1876. There's two other places you can make overrides. You can override right here with the hours, and you can override right here with the dollars. So I could change this to 8, and I could change this here to 600, let's say. Okay. The problem with changing items here and here is that the job cost doesn't know what to do with these numbers. When I changed it in the difficulty factor and I changed it down here on these speakers, it was directly related to the proposal and how the proposal was designed. There's no way for the program to know where these numbers should be assigned. So I generally recommend don't make the change here. Make the change on the difficulty factor, make the change on an individual item if you need to. And if you find you're making the same change over and over again, then what you need to do is you need to go back and look at your individual items and decide maybe up your numbers or lower your numbers depending on what's happening. So we'll hit update one more time. Update all of our numbers. We'll go back to money detail. And now we're at 37,612. So we say, okay, that's great. That's what I want to give the person. So there's a couple of other things you want to do to prepare this proposal prior to pushing it into an advanced proposal design. We're going to come back under proposal setup. And the first thing we're going to look at would be a button here called Zone Discipline Subzone. Now what this does is this decides how the proposal is going to be presented. Are we going to present it in a discipline zone or in a zone discipline? And to go over the difference for those who are not familiar, discipline zone, as an example, we have Whole House Music and all the rooms that Whole House Music goes into. Under zone discipline, we would have the rooms and the disciplines that populate those rooms. So it just depends on how you want to portray your proposal. I typically do mine in discipline zone. So I'll change that back. Now this is the area where we can put some text in to describe the process or the package that we're putting in here. So for instance, I have created a Word document that describes the disciplines. And we can go to that Word document, open it up, and then copy and paste the items that are in here into that section. So if I look for Whole House Music, for instance, here's my Whole House Music package. So I might want to take that section right there, hit Control C to copy it, go back into SmartOffice, and now I'm going to highlight Whole House Music, and I'm going to paste that in. Now I can manipulate how this is going to look, and I can change any of the dialogue here as well. So for instance, maybe I want the Whole House Music to be down one, because I'm going to have a bar or a header going across that page, and I want it to be a little bit lower. So as we read through here, we make sure that everything is described appropriately. You can, like I said, customize it. In any way you want to customize that. We can also say specific things. So for instance, that living room, okay, we've got our living room package right here. If I click on the box again, I could type in the faux painted grills are at the client's not mercy, they're at the client's request and are not warranted for sound quality due to painting issues. Whatever. Put whatever kind of note you want to put in there. And what that'll do is that'll put that right in the living room, right above there, where we see the speakers. So that's two ways you can get some notes in there, essentially, kind of describing more specifically what you're doing. The next area under proposal setup, your software probably says description right here. Mine says scope of work. When you click on scope of work, ahead of time you want to build, for instance, a welcome letter or a scope of work letter, essentially. And the way you do that is you click on Edit Boilerplate Text. Under Edit Boilerplate Text, the first thing you want to do is decide on the filter. So we open this box up, and again, there's an Edit button. So we can edit all the things that are in here. You always want the word all to be in there, and then you can also filter by, for instance, welcome, I put scope of work, drawings, etc. Click on New Boilerplate Text, and that will give us a blank canvas to work from. You can then give it a title, so you know whatever you want to put in here, just as an example. You select that, that title is going to pop down here. I'll go ahead and get rid of that because we're not going to use that. But as an example, so here's the welcome letter. So XYZ welcome letter, and it welcomes the client or the prospect. And then over here, we'll choose, I typically choose start a new paragraph, so it puts a little bit of space in between things. And then you click on where you want this to show up in the filter. And what I mean by that is, once you're all done creating these boilerplate texts, then you're going to come into scope of work in your proposal mode, and you're going to choose which ones you want. So we can filter that by, if I'm looking just for the welcome letter, there's the welcome letter under that welcome. There's my scope of work. Or if you don't have a lot of them, then all works fine. So I might want to put the welcome letter in. I might also want to put my scope of work in. And then once I click update, it'll bring it into this box here. Once it's into this box, I can now again adjust this. So I might want to put on here Ed, kind of personalize it. And then I think my scope of work has a name in it in here. Yep, there's Mr. and Mrs. Joe Average. So I'll change that to Ed Can Buy. And it's proposal 3156, for instance. Okay. So I've made those minor changes, and it's customized it for Ed. And lastly, in terms of preparing to move this over to Advanced Proposal Design, we'll go to Notes and Conditions. Notes and Conditions works exactly the same way. There's the same edit boilerplate text. Sorry. In this section, so this works exactly the same way. So when you come to Notes and Conditions, the only one thing I have in here is XYZ Audio Video Contract. So I'll click on that and update it. And here's where we can put the, this is the 7th day of May. And it's 2009, for instance. So I can make those changes. Okay, so that's all the changes I need to do on the front end before I move over to Advanced Proposal Design. And just to cover scope of work and the notes and conditions, what scope of work does is it creates a section in front of the body of the proposal, and notes and conditions creates a page that can be put at the end of the proposal for your contract. So let's go to List as Client, and now we'll go to Advanced Proposal Design. And when I click Advanced Proposal Design, it's going to then start up Advanced Proposal Design and load whatever you have set as your standard or your default package. So let's talk about setting up a package next. So the first thing you want to do when you open up Advanced Proposal Design, you want to come to Settings. You probably want to come to Graphics first. Click on Logo, and then come down here to Add New Logo. So I'll click Add New Logo. It'll build a box right there, A New Logo 5/7/2008. When you click on any of these three open boxes, it's going to take you to our cache folder where we store all of our images. But from there, we can navigate out. So for instance, I can go to C here. I think I have it under my website, and there's my logo. So I'll put my logo right there. Now we can continue to do the same thing across here, but once it's in this slot, if you right click and then close that cache folder, right click one more time, you can now copy and simply paste the file references in there. You need to continue to get these out of the way in order to do that. It takes two hits to make that happen. And so now they're in there. Once they're in there, then I want to come back into here and put maybe a new TCL logo, for instance. So it's at the top, I can find it a little easier. So it's right there. Now that your logo's in there, the next step we want to look at is we want to start deciding what title page we like the best. So if you come to Title Styles and we come to System, I had mine on Custom. So here's System, and I'm missing this file apparently. But you see these other ones across here. So I can pick a cover. This is page 1, page 2, page 3. I guess we're at page 3 at this point. So perhaps the one that I like the best would be, let's say this one here. So we'll select the Alston. So now that that's selected, I want to customize this for my company. So I'm going to go to Settings, and this will tell you all about the graphics that you're seeing on here. So it's going to tell you the 10-10 is referring to the layout. This is how the designers have laid out where this bar is going to be and how this couch fits, essentially. The gradient background title image, which is this piece right here, it's going to tell you it's 611 pixels by 293 pixels. This photo image is 210 by 87, and the logo that goes down here is 174 by 87. So if you wanted to change this out and get rid of the couch, for instance, and put something else there, you could do that simply by adding an item to the graphics that was the same size as this, and then we can swap that out. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So let's say we like this, and that's fine. Next thing we want to do is we want to edit the text that goes at the top. You'll see there's a title text and there's info text. And the way that works is we've got text here and we've got text here. So it's going to depend on where those items go. So this text says it's in tan. Well, maybe I want to do something obnoxious like yellow. And I don't want it to be bold, but maybe I want it to be in italics. And maybe I want it's in book antique, maybe I want it in Arial. So you can make those changes. Next one down here is going to give us company name, company slogan, the phone number. Maybe I don't want that stuff on there, so I can clear it out. And by the way, you can do the same thing here, same set of buttons. So I've cleared that out. So maybe what I want in here is the company name, and then I'm going to do a carriage return, and maybe I just want the company address next. So that's all that's on there. And I'm going to turn this to be green, something really obnoxious. just to show you, you can make these things as beautiful and or as strange as you'd like. It's totally up to you. Once that's all done, then I want to do a save as. So I'm going to save as, and I'm going to just call this we'll just call this Alliston Training. But you would obviously put your company name there. I suggest that putting the company name there works, so I would put it up front here, like XYZ, but I would keep the Alliston there as well, because it'll kind of give you a reference back as to where you got it from. And your client's never going to see that, so it just makes it easier for you. So I'm going to click OK, and what this will do is go out there and save it, and then create a preview for it. Okay, and there's our preview of the title header, or the title page, sorry. The next thing you typically want to look at would be the body styles. So if I click on body styles here, again, change it to system. As we start to look through the body styles, if you recall a few minutes ago, we talked about how the body style was laid out. And right now, as I mouse over these, you'll see about two-thirds of the way down, you'll see the word sort order. That one was just up there was sort order ZDS. This one here says sort order to ZDS. ZDS again being zone discipline subsystem or subzone. I get over to Brighton here. Now this one is DZS, and that's what I wanted to use. I wanted to use a DZS. So I could say, okay, yep, I like the Brighton, so I'm going to select Brighton. Now it's selected with its red outline box around it. So again, I can go under settings. And under settings, this is where we have our business rules. So this is how you want the proposal to look, how the financials are kind of represented, so to speak. So in this case, it's set up that accessories are hidden, and that's fine. I want to keep it that way. It's not using sectional page numbers. In this case, I want to use sectional page numbers. So what that will do is instead of the entire document just saying page 1 of 49, for instance, there's three areas that we just got done building. The scope, and the terms, also known as notes and conditions, and then the body style that will each have multiple pages per section. So body style, for instance, will be represented by saying section C, page 1 of 30, for instance. So I want to use that. Show prices. Yes, I do want to show prices, and I want to show unit prices. Maybe I want everything to be priced out individually. And then show extended prices. So the unit price would be the individual speaker at $300, let's say, but you're getting two pairs, so it would be, the extended would be $600. Add labels to prices. Yes, I want to do that. What that will do is just put the word price. This over here is the extended dollar amount. The unit price is inside here in the body, so it'll just have the word price and then that number right there. I do want to add line feeds to the summaries. That gives a little more space. I do want to show the item graphics. Typically, if you're doing discipline zone subzone versus zone discipline subzone, we want to break on the discipline and not break on the zone. I don't want to include the discount in the line items. I want to have all this stuff separately, so I'm going to have the discount, the miscellaneous, and the labor all separate. And we'll leave it at that. This section here are the graphics. How do we want the graphics to look? Well, I'm not using a zone graphic because I'm using a discipline graphic. So under here, our choices are the three, none, or the singles. So the singles look like this, and then these are the ones I like the most, which are the triples. Then this has this blueprint type look to it, but with that front cover I chose, that's not going to look quite right because it's going to be a totally different color scheme. So I'm going to change and say maybe I want to do sepia. And then for the gradient, I'll use a sepia and a yellow. So that'll change the whole look of the proposal. Now the page header. What do I want to see at the top of every page? The way it's set up, it's showing client, the proposal name, and the proposal number. Well, maybe I just want the proposal number up there, for instance. Or maybe I just want the proposal name. You can change it to whatever you want. So maybe I just want proposal name and proposal number. And I just want to go across the top. Our section headers. What this allows us to do is change the color of the discipline header, the zone header, or the subzone header, or the section headers. So I might want to leave, yeah, black's fine, I'll leave it the way it is, but maybe I want it in italics. Your line items. This is how it's going to read across. So right now we have turned on the quantity, the unit of measure, the make, the SKU, the description, the product text, and the price. Okay. Actually, product text is off, I'm sorry. So maybe I want to just adjust completely how this is done. So I can clear it, and I can say, okay, I do want to see quantity, and then I want to see unit of measure, and then I want to see the make, but I don't want to show them the SKU because I don't want to give them a laundry list to go out and shop me on. So I'll hit description. I want product text on there. And then the item price. We go to section summaries. This describes how we want the proposal to total up. So I want to just show the discipline, but I want to show materials, discount, miscellaneous, everything. So I want to total on all those. I don't want any zone summaries, and I don't want any subzone summaries. And maybe I want the price to be in, the final price here to be in sepia. See what happens with that. How interesting that looks. And then our footer. So at the bottom of the footer, we're going to see page B-069. That's fine. And then we're going to have our address and everything down here. And again, maybe I want to change these things to kind of match the tone of what we're doing. We'll put sepia on there. So once that's all done, we're going to click Save As. And if you recall what I said, I want to leave the name Brighton there. But maybe I just want to change this to Training, or your company name. Okay. So now this will go out and save this as well. Okay, so there's my Brighton Training. Now that I have those two items, those are the two most difficult items or the biggest decisions to make, I should say, in terms of how your proposal is going to look. Now what I want to do is I want to create a style set. So if I click on Style Set, I'm going to select this secondary button right here. Actually, under System, you'll see all the style sets here. I'm going to select this, and I've got Alston Training here, and I've got my training here, but what I want to make sure of is I want to make sure that the scope and the summaries and the terms, that the header graphic size matches. And the best way to do that is, if you recall, we did this one right here under, no, I think it was under Brighton, yeah. It was a Brighton copy that was on there. So if I go to my style sets and I look under Brighton, here's my Brighton. If I select Brighton now and then hit select here, now I'm going to change this to the Alston Training, and I'm going to change this to the Brighton Training. And I'm going to change the logo to a new TCL logo. Once that's all done, now I can hit Save As. And again, I'll call this the Brighton Copy or Brighton Training. 57. Now it's going to save that entire style set for us. And we'll make this our default style set. So every time we open this package up, it will open up to that design. And there's our design right there. So I'm going to create that as the default. And then we'll select that. Okay. Now, as I mentioned, okay, so there's what it's going to look like essentially. Okay. Now, next time we go to SmartOffice, and we click on Advanced Proposal Design, when it opens it up, it's going to open it up to our design, the one that we've saved. Okay. So now that it's done that, the next thing we want to do is now we want to see what the proposal looks like. So we're going to go to Reload Proposal. And what this is doing is, it requires a little bit of explanation about how APD works versus how Simply Reliable's SmartOffice works. SmartOffice's database is designed to be set in a single place. So there'll be a folder with a host in it, whether it's on the network or on an individual peer-to-peer situation on an individual laptop or a PC workstation. Advanced Proposal Design, because of the graphical nature of the device or of the software, it's designed to reside on the laptop or the workstation of the person who's actually creating the proposals. So you'll have lots and lots of copies of APD out there, even if people are connecting via terminal server to get to the SmartOffice package. Okay, so we've got our body here, and we see here's our graphic header. We've got our description, and we've got dining room, and you can see how the dollars flow on this. Here's that section I put in having to do with these speakers. And then here's our total. So we've got subtotal, miscellaneous, labor, and total. Here's our home theater. And there's the total for the home theater. So we like that, we're satisfied with it. So the next thing we want to do is we want to get it out to the client, or the prospect. So we'll come to the print button, and what the print button does is bring up this screen right here. And there are some decisions that you can make in this section as well. So what sections do I want to include? Well, this is a pretty full proposal. I want the title page, I want the scope of work, I want the body, the summary, the terms, and I want any product cut sheets included as well. And I'm going to talk for a minute about product cut sheets and company profile. This section over here says company profile. If you guys have written a profile of the company, kind of describing what you're all about, that type of thing, you can tell the system where you have that saved, go out and browse to it and click on it, and then you can choose to add that to the proposal if you like. And that's added up front with the scope of work. Next decision I want to make here is we got feedback from you guys out in the field that said you wanted some of you guys wanted your summary to be here and some of you wanted your summary after the terms. So this button right here allows you to place the terms section ahead of the summary section. So I'm going to do that in this case. Okay. And Ed's email address has come in here. So I could simply click Create PDF and mail to client, and it'll build the PDF, create an email, and send it out. Of course, this is a fake address, so I'm not going to send it to a fake address. If I want to just print it so I can print it, you know, and bind it, Then we can come to Print Document to PDF. And what this is going to do is I'm going to push this button. It's going to go through a series of making those individual PDFs for all those individual pages, and then it's going to put them all together in one single PDF. So you'll see it's building each section as we go. And once that's complete, it's going to then open that either in, if you have PDF 995 as your PDF builder, it'll open that. I happen to use Acrobat, so it's going to open up under Acrobat for mine. And there's our proposal. So we come through. There's our page A1 of 4, I think it says. This is our welcome letter, our scope of work. And then section B, we get into the body. And then finally our terms. And then there's our summary. And then this is a really cool feature. So at the end, it has taken any of the cut sheets that I have assigned and put them at the end. So here's my Epson cut sheet. And the way this happens under your product details pages. You guys won't see this until the update comes out, and the update's going to go to beta next week. You're actually seeing the current beta version right now, or alpha, I guess, that I'm testing. Under products, if I go to product list and I go to Epson and I go to that projector, you'll see down here there's a new box called cut sheets in browse. So if I click on Browse, I can go out and point where that cut sheet is located at. And then as long as I have chosen, under the Print tab, the product cut sheets, it will find any of the product cut sheets in any of the proposal, or any of the items in the proposal that have cut sheets attached to them, and it will then print them out. And that's proposals and using APD. So at this time, I'll take any questions that you guys might have. And I want to thank everybody for joining me.